Last time on Deconverted Man.
Dem Feind gelungen, die Front in breiter Formation zu durchbrechen. Im Süden hat der Gegner Zossen genommen und stößt auf Stahnsdorf vor. Der Feind operiert jetzt am nördlichen Stadtrand zwischen Frohnau und Pankow. Und im Osten ist der Feind bis zur Linie Lichtenberg-Marsdorf-Karlshorst gelangt.
Mit dem Angriff Steiners wird das alles in Ordnung kommen.
Mein Führer, Steiner
konnte nicht genügend Kräfte für einen Angriff massieren. Der Angriff Steiner ist nicht erfolgt.
Es bleiben im Raum Keitel, Jodl, Krebs und Burgdorf. Das war ein Befehl! Der Angriff Steiners war ein Befehl! Wer schickt Sie?
Das hier ist Wagen! Sie mein Befehl zu ihr setzen! So weit ist das also gekommen. Der Militär hat mich verlogen!
Jeder hat mich verlogen, sogar die SS! Die gesamte Generalität ist nichts weiter als ein Haufen niederträchtiger, treuloser Feiglinge!
Mein Führer, ich kann nicht zulassen, dass die Soldaten, die für Sie verbringen...
Bist das Feiglinge? Verräter, Versager!
Mein Führer, was Sie da sagen, ist ungeheuerlich!
Die Generalität ist das Geschmolz des deutschen Volkes! Sie ist ohne Ehre! Sie nennen sich Generale, weil Sie Jahre auf Militärakademien zugebracht haben, nur um zu lernen, wie man Messer und Gabel hält!
Jahrelang hat das Militär meine Aktionen nur behindert. Es hat mich gegen nur erfüllten
Widerstand in den Weg gelegt. Ich hätte gut daran getan, von Jahren alle höheren Offiziere registrieren zu lassen, wie Stalin.
Ich war nie auf einer Akademie. Und doch habe ich allein auf mich gestellt. Ganz Europa erobert. Verräter! Von allem Anfang an bin ich so verraten und betrogen worden. Es wurde ein ungeheurer Verrat geübt am deutschen Volke. Aber alle diese Verräter werden bezahlen. Mit ihrem eigenen Blut werden sie bezahlen. Sie werden es saufen in ihrem eigenen Blut.
Bitte gerne. Jetzt beruhig dich doch.
Meine Befehle sind in den Wind gesprochen. Es ist unmöglich, unter diesen Umständen zu führen. Es ist aus. Der Krieg ist verloren. Aber wenn Sie, meine Herren, glauben, dass ich deswegen Berlin verlasse, irren Sie sich gewaltig. Eher jage ich mir eine Kugel durch den Kopf. Tun Sie, was Sie wollen.
Now we have fine medical system in our body. We just said, if you see multiple sets of backup systems, it cannot be the result of random chances. They must be by design.
Acupuncture is not based on biology. It is based on a wide range of philosophies about the human body. Its core claim revolves around qi and the supposed pathways in the body called meridians, that they're blocked or they're out of balance. And the needles in acupuncture are placed in areas believed to be areas where these meridians cross. No proof of qi is available. No proof of the meridians are available. No mapping of the human body to any relevant biology is available, although several maps are available of the meridian channels, and which one you use and why is up to the practitioner. The arrival of kui, de kui, sensation, is a numbness or a distension or an electrical tingling that if it's not produced is blamed either on the patient not being strong enough, or it might be the depth that the needle was wrong, or the needle was not put in the right way. And then if it doesn't work, then they try plucking or shaking or trembling techniques. In other words, if it doesn't work, it's anything and everything's fault, and we keep going and trying until it works. And then if it doesn't work, then it's never the fault of the treatment. It must be the person doing the treatment or receiving it at fault. Let me read a bit about traditional Chinese medicine here. The main physiological functions of the heart are dominating, in charge of governing or controlling, the blood and vessels and manifesting shows on the face. Its main function is to propel the blood. The heart is the motivating force, pump, for blood circulation. The propulsion of blood relies on the heart qi. If heart qi rises, the result is a rosy face. Housing the mind in traditional Chinese medicine, the mind is equivalent to consciousness and the heart is the resident of the spirit. Therefore, mental activities are functions of the heart. These include spirit, consciousness, thinking, memory, and sleep. Blood is the principal material basis that enables these functions, and it is controlled by the heart. No to all of that. Just no. The heart pumps blood. You got that much right. But the rest is just nonsense. And you wouldn't add that in unless you believed that this stuff wasn't nonsense. The whole she stuff. And then, of course, I would have to ask, if you got a heart transplant, does that mean that you're switching out your spirit with somebody else's spirit? Like, how does that work? Am I now that person? Or do I just have their spirit? What about the soul? Is that the same thing? How does any of this work? Every test that has been conducted on this, that has been a double-blind methodology involved, has returned results that we would expect from chance alone, or the placebo effect. So, there you go. There's nothing to it. It's not a proven science. It's just a belief. Okay, what about reflexology, you ask? So glad you asked. Reflexology, or something like it, has been around for a while in China and Egypt, but it was introduced in the United States in 1913 by William H. Fersengold, not going to pronounce his name right anytime soon, who was a ear, nose, and throat specialist, and some guy named Edwin Bowers. The doctor's claim was that applying pressure had an anesthetic effect on other areas of the body. You see, there's these zones and reflex areas that reflect an image of the body on the feet and hands. So if you mess about with that, then you affect the body. You want proof of that? Too bad! There is none! Studies have shown this to yield what we would expect from chance or the placebo effect. There's no biology to back it up. One doctor and one random dude do not a medical science make. This and acupuncture both have these, quote, maps, end quote, that map, not enough quotes in the universe, to the human body. Based on what? Oh, right, someone's just made the maps up. So any patterns that are there because somebody put them there. There's no evidence that any of this works at all. Several questions spring to my mind. With acupuncture, do they use new needles every time? And can they ensure that the surface I'm going to lie on is sterilized? What about hand washing and gloves? Can I be sure about any of this? If something goes wrong, who do I sue? Are they making any positive claims that this will do something? Or are they making vague claims that this has been known to help something? If the idea of reflexology is that your hands or feet have pressure points that affect your body, Wouldn't dropping a hammer on your foot or hand make your body react in some huge negative way? What if you lose your hand or your foot? Wouldn't that cause severe damage to the parts of the body that the foot or the hand are mapped to? Let alone, what if you're not born with a foot or a hand? Then what? Neither of these practices are based on science. Neither of them are proven to work. And anything that you could say that this show's design is invalid, because the only design that it can show is humans who made up the maps. And it certainly doesn't point to a divine origin of any sort.
Therefore, we are by design. I'm a mathematician. In math, we have something called the Fibonacci numbers. It's a series of numbers starting from two ones. The next number is the sum of the two previous numbers. Therefore, we have 1 plus 1 equal 2, 2 plus 1 equal 3, and 3 plus 2 is 5, and so forth. From Fibonacci numbers, you can also obtain a Fibonacci curve showing on the right. If you look at the living things, they all obey the Fibonacci numbers.
Everywhere I see them there, I stop and stare at patterns. I don't care, I must declare, I got a flair for patterns. On my hair, the clothes I wear, my savoir-faire is patterns. All I see are patterns, the patterns that repeat.
There's no denying that patterns exist almost everywhere that we look because, well, we're pattern seekers and we will find patterns even when there are none to find. Here's some examples. There are four chords that make up a number of songs. The Axels of Awesome made a video about this phenomenon. Now, why these four chords? Well, they're pleasing to our ears. Is that by design or necessity? After all, did God make these four chords for us to enjoy? Or is it just that we happen to enjoy these four chords? The, of, and, to, a, in, is, I, that, it, for, you, was, with, on, as, have, but, be, they are the most used words in the English language in order. Vsauce did a video about this as well as some other phenomenon as well. Why do these things have this pattern? Don't know. Maybe they just do. Not because of any common creator, which your previous argument alluded to, that the same building blocks are used, that indicates the same creator that use those building blocks to build everything. Gravity makes things into spheres. So is that by design, or is that simply the simplest shape that things can collapse into when gravity is in effect? Maybe the patterns are there because of the laws of nature, and maybe you want to say that the laws of nature are created by God. But if that's the case, then you can't also make the argument that the patterns are separate creations of God. The patterns have to be there out of necessity to align with the easiest way to form in the nature that is made, if nature is made in the first place at all, which you haven't shown or demonstrated. Simply saying, look, patterns. Okay, and so what? If the reverse was true and there wasn't patterns, and everything was unique and different, well, then you would just point to that and say, look, no patterns. See, that's the problem with God, is it's unfalsifiable. There is no one or multiple thing that I could point to or discover, and that you would then say, oh, well, I guess that means that there is no God. Because God isn't framed in the scientific framework, it's framed in a philosophical pinning framework. And the idea of God might be interesting to explore, but the actual God, well, we need some reason to think that it is there. and simply pointing out patterns that we would expect to see in a universe that is constrained by the laws that it has is not too surprising. A universe without God would have these patterns. A universe with God doesn't have to have these patterns at all, because, well, God can do anything, right? So God didn't have to make it in a way that looks like a universe without God.
If you count the number of petals in the flower, it always will be one of the Fibonacci numbers. This is a cactus, sunflower, even the star formations are following the Fibonacci numbers. A few years ago, a teenager did a solar power experiment, and he found out using a tree with leaf of Fibonacci numbers, he would get the best result. In fact, if you extend the leaves on the trees, they all follow the Fibonacci numbers to receive the best amount of sunshine. How amazing is that?
Blah, blah, patterns, Fibonacci, golden ratio, blah, blah, blah. That's the rest of this bit. So, it's the same argument. It's not really even an argument, but he wants it to be an argument. Repeat it over and over and over again. Also, he repeats it some more, just in case you didn't get it the first time. Yeah, we get it. You're impressed by the patterns. Moving on.
There's one kind of cobra in Africa called a spitting cobra. One time, a lion came to harass the snake, wanting to eat him. The snake uses the eyes to aim at the eye of the lion, and then it splits the venom. As you can see, the snake does not have sharp teeth, so teeth are not the weapon. But it spits into two strings of liquids. As far as I know, the venom in the snake body, because they are separate, which is not harmful to the snake. Yet, when it spits on the lion's eyes, it immediately creates a chemical reaction that turns into poison. The lion's eye might be blind because of that.
Oh, let me guess. You don't know how this works, so it must be by design, right? Hey, take your bets now in the comments below. Is Deconverted Man right? Is he going to just say, like, you know, oh man, the venom, it's not poisonous to the snake, but it's poisonous to the lion. It's got to be designed. Can't be anything else.
What do you see? The venom is not harmful to the snake yet, become poison to the lion. It must be by design. Therefore, the universe is by design.
Hold on, that's a non sequitur. You see, even if the snake was by design, which you haven't shown or demonstrated in any way, shape, or form, that doesn't mean that the universe is also then by design. So, oops.
There are many areas of knowledge we can study. If the world was through evolution, for example, physics and chemistry would evolve by themselves. We should see many conflicts between the physics and the chemistry. And yet, everything in chemistry and physics is congruous with each other. Not just that, all areas of knowledge are congruous with each other. Why? Because the Bible says, "In the beginning was the Word." Everything was derived from one reason from God. Therefore, there are no conflicts.
Physics and chemistry would evolve on their own if evolution was true. That's what he said. That is what he said. No to that idea? Evolution, like, slow change throughout time. I mean, that's the basic definition of evolution. I think I can feel that my brain is melted here. And I think I'm going to go ahead and get some needles and just go ahead and shove them into my brain. And that will make this make sense, maybe. No to that idea. The mentioning the Bible, no to that, don't care, it's circular. No.